Loving it, no need to rehash what everyone has posted previously. Hoping to see full-fledged games releasing on PSVR in the future. I can't wait to see an open world RPG in VR update. Been playing PSVR with the family for a week and they like it. I'm hoping Sony will make the eye distance calibration more user-friendly by saving previous user settings. Games are great and I suggest trying out Batman VR as this is the only game so far that showcase the graphical capability of PSVR. Next, try Rush of Blood and Here They Lie. All good released games. Own this and the Vive. Like the video quality, text is easy to read. Things like this makes me excited about technology and hungry for more. Absolutely amazing. It is so much fun. I am looking forward to more games for it. Great hardware, very comfortable Sony made setup and installation, very simple and easy, and it comes with a demo disc. The last time I saw a console or hardware with a demo was on the PS2. Overall, the VR experience on PlayStation was defining. Sony should still make more products and gadgets as they are lacking. Worthy. Talks of Vive and Oculus will try to convince you that PSVR is no real contender. But once the PS helmet is on, we are graciously welcomed to the future. On an original PS4, I've experienced no lag, outstanding graphics, and accurate motion, helmet, and camera detection. No nausea for me as speculated by many people. My theory is that this only affects certain users. If you are as impatient a gamer as me and you don't feel like waiting for more cheap bundles to be restocked, then the helmet alone priced a little over $500 is still worth it. I found wires were surprisingly not uncomfortable. I find it best consumers know that majority of PSVR games are to be played in a seated position. Few exceptions for standing, with games like Batman Arkham VR.